Good morning students, welcome back to the English channel for grade 7. Students, today in this video I'll give you the summary or gist of the unit 4 under the prose section named The Blind Dog. It's a very heartwarming and sensitive story of a dog written by R.K. Narayan. So before starting, let's know about the author R.K. Narayan. Children, R.K. Narayan's full name was Rasipuram Krishnaswamy Iyer Narayan Swamy. He was India's greatest English language novelist. He used to write in English and he is known for his novels based in the fictional town of Malgudi. He was born on 10th October 1906. R.K. Narayan began his writing career with Swamy and friends in 1935. Most of his work, including Swamy and friends, is set in the fictional town of Malgudi, which captures everything Indian, while having a unique identity of its own. His writing style was marked by simplicity and subtle humor. He told stories of ordinary people trying to live in their simple lives in a changing world. Children, he had got many numerous awards like the National Prize of Sahitya Academy, and he also had got the Indian Library Academy. He was honored with Padma Bhushan and also with Padma Vibhushan Award. He was passed on May 13, 2001. So children, let's now start about the story. This lesson, The Blind Dog, is a short narrative written by R.K. Narayan. As I said, this story is about a faithful street dog and a blind beggar. The writer describes how human beings treat animals and their incompassionate, means merciless, attitude towards animals. R.K. Narayan is an intrepid storyteller, means fearless storyteller, and this story narrates the harrowing, the distressful and inconsiderate attitude of human beings towards animals. Students, some people very nicely behaves with the animals or treats the animals very friendly, but some people torture them like anything. So in this story, we'll learn about such a man. See children, every living being is born free, but human nature tries to capture and bind animals for its own selfishness. Students, the title of the story may mislead us. Here, the dog is not the one who is blind, but it befriends, it accompanies a blind man. Blind literally means to be not able to see. This is what the writer actually wants to convey to his students or readers here. The blind beggar could not see that animals like dogs also need the freedom to live their own lives. The dog is blind with his faithfulness towards the blind beggar. It could not see how inconsiderate, how merciless, and how incompassionate, how cruel the blind man was. The dog is blinded by loyalty and the blind man is blinded by his dependency on the dog when he takes it for granted and treats it like a slave. The blind dog here illustrates the dilemma of the street dog Tom between his own freedom and his loyalty towards the blind man. This dog was not a very impressive or a high-class dog. It was a commonplace dog which you can see everywhere. And its color is white and dusty. Its tail was mutilated at the young age. Means it was disfigured at a young age because of some types of fight perhaps. It was born on the streets and grew up feeding on the garbage of the marketplace. The dog had spotty eyes and an unimpressive body, but he was short-tempered or It is called pugnacious. Pugnacious meaning he was very aggressive. He was quick to argue because he was orphan. He has nobody to take care. His body was scared because of numerous. His body was scarred because of numerous fights. Means has a lot of marks because of numerous fights with other dogs. He took rest under a culvert. Culvert means a small stream or the drain in the market during the afternoons. In the evenings, he spent his time loitering in the streets. Loitering meaning moving around or roaming around the streets and fighting with other dogs and forage for food. Forage means for searching for food, he used to roam here and there in the market. He spent his nights at the market itself. But after 3 years, his life underwent a drastic change, means a very big change. One day, while it was sleeping at the marketplace, it was stirred by the smell of food. He saw a blind beggar eating his sparse meal. Sparse means scattered, dispersed meal. He approached the man with expectant eyes. The dog approached the man, means asked the man with an expectant eyes, and the man stroked it gently and threw a handful of food at it. The man also very soberly gave him little food. The dog ate the food gratefully and thus their friendship started. It means it got sealed. Their friendship became stronger. The beggar was looked after by an old woman up to that time. After befriending the beggar, the dog spent most of its time with the beggar now. It defended the beggar from being harassed. A village urchin. Urchin means a small boy who is poorly dressed, of 10 to 11 year old, stole the blind beggar's coins and teased him, used to trouble him. This had been going on every Thursday when the boy would come to the market to sell vegetables. On Thursday, when the boy was up to his usual mischief, usual troublance, the faithful dog chased that boy out of the market. The old woman who had been looking after the beggar died after some days, and the beggar was now left home without anybody. The ribbon seller gave the blind beggar a length of ribbon so that he could tie it around the dog's neck and it could lead him about. Now the dog became his identity. That means he started befriending with the dog and depending on the dog for going back to his home. Now the dog lost its freedom completely. The blind man depended on the dog and his dependency made him into a merciless slave or driver. The blind man started earning more because he could move about the marketplace now because of the dog, with the dog leading him everywhere. It became a slave to its master. The dog protected the blind man from all dangers, and the blind man now became wholly dependent on the dog, both for making a living and also to live. Because of him, he could walk everywhere and could ask for more money or can beg through more visiting more places. He was possessive about the dog and even slept with the dog's leash turned around his finger. Now, slowly, this blind man became very possessive about the dog. That means he doesn't want to let the dog go out of his capture. So he used to hold his rope while sleeping. The dog was virtually imprisoned and binded to the old man. If the dog grew tired of walking around leading the blind man, he would goad it on fiercely with his staff. That means he started torturing. Goad means he would drive him with a spike stick and stabbing him, that means pressing him hard, fiercely, very heavily with his staff, with the stick. At night, people could hear the dog's tired wailing, tired shouting, stabbing the night air, pressing the night air. Before long, the dog appeared to be more bones, mere bones and skin. It became very weak. He became very thin. And the raven seller, the noble vendor and the perfumer who had observed him with this condition of the dog, they sympathized with it. They became considerable towards him. They became kind towards him. The blind man was now earning more than he required, and he started lending money even for interest. That means now he is slowly getting more money and becoming richer because of this dog. But his greediness grew, but the dog grew thinner and thinner. One day, the perfumer borrowed the scissors from the ribbon vendor and caught up the dog's leash. The dog had regained his freedom. He ran away and happily roamed about the marketplace. Students, now the dog was free. He had gained his freedom. He ran away and happily roamed about the marketplace. The blind man was now without any protector. He stumbled and groped about the marketplace. That means he could not lead his life now without the dog. He was stopped at one place. His life became standstill, but still he was yelling at the dog, thinking that he will murder if he could see the dog again. But without the dog, his life was perished. He could not lead his life. But after more than 20 days, the dog returned to his master, and the heartless beggar thought that the dog returned to him because of hunger. He now binded the dog with a steel chain. The dog and the blind man were as usual seen roaming about the marketplace. Students, here the blind man was a very cruel and inconsiderate person, because the whole time he thought of murdering him, and even when the dog came back to him, he gave him a big blow which he could never forget. So here the blind man thinks that the dog didn't get any food, and out of hunger he has driven back to him. But this is not the case. The dog is a real loyal and faithful animal, and because of it, he again came back to this blind person. Seeing all this, the raven vendor commented that death alone can help that dog. And with a sigh, he continued that nobody could help a creature who returns to his doom, means to his destruction, to his death, with such a free heart. So this is the summary of this story written by R.K. Narayan. Hope you understand, children. There are many difficult words. So along with the glossaries given in the book, I'll give you all hard words and their meaning. Let's start. First word, pangs, means pain. Metalited means disfigured. Prevention means stop. Mongrel means a dog having parents of two different types of breeds. Loaf means doing nothing. Skirmishes means fighting or clash. Rascal means mischievous. Fretting means worry. Sprang means hunting or hunt. Extricated means free, release. Instinct means stimuli, a stimulus behavior. Impulse again means the same urge or stimulation. Whine means complaining or a long cry. Tyrant means a cruel oppressed ruler. Tyrant means a Greek cruel oppressed ruler. Lumbered means tumbled. Haunches means thighs or the hips. Rents means split or tear apart. Taut means tightened or stretched. Snipped means caught. Pugnacity means aggressive or quick to argue. Forage means searching widely for food. Sparse means scattered. Urchin means mischievous, poorly dressed young boy. Lease means the rope. Goad means driving with a or drive work with a spiked stick. Stubbing means striking or pressing. Scourge means a troublant boy. And culvert means a passage for wastewater that passes under the road or stream. Steed means attracted. Leer means sly, unpleasant look. Circumscribed means kept within narrow limits. Hunt meaning familiar places. Orbit means here the restricted path. Lumber means causing difficulty by giving unwanted responsibility. Haunches, bone of back leg standing out. So these are the difficult words. Hope you understand. Thank you. Any doubt? Please comment, like, share and subscribe. Thank you again.